Yeah, please see. Good morning to one and all. Once again, good morning. Hope you are able to see the Explorer, right? Explorer. Last class, we have discussed about all those things. I have started the Explorer. Whenever I pressed on this, please recollect, this entire thing, entire VECA is developed by using JDK. That's why whatever the commands you use for creating a simple guide button, what type of interface you require, split panel, everything is, you can recollect and you can use while developing the project work, right? Open file, I am opening the, some data set I need to load, right or not? Program files, where is VECA? Data, in data folder contains the data set. Friends, please remember here, not only these data set, you can download data sets which are available in UCI California website, and at the same time, not only downloading, you need to perform simple modifications and name that file as ARFF. What is that ARFF? Attribute relation file format, okay? You need to change the downloaded data set into in this. What is this? How can we change? Last time I have presented, I have opened Iris ARFF using WordPad, right or not? Whenever you opened using WordPad, you able to see the data set, percentage relation, percentage attributes, what type of attributes, what is the target class, everything they mentioned very clearly, right or not? Let me admit one more person came. If they come, we will not have this disturbance like this. Yeah, coming to this one, please see, last class, simply I loaded the data set and presented the visualization portion and the exploring the data set, right or not? Last class, our target was exploring the data set. This class, our target is to utilize some sort of filtering technique, and at the same time, if possible, we will go for visualization also. Sorry, we will go for classification also. Please see, now current relation is Iris. Very, in 1 minute, I want to complete the last class review. Iris, total instances, that is total objects are 150, five attributes are there, that five attributes including the target class, class label, right? Please see, class label, sum of weights are how many? 150, means total number of objects are 150. Selected attribute, whatever the attribute I have selected my cursor, that attribute details are mentioned here. There are three types of classes, yes or not? Three types of classes are there. Three types of classes, Iris Sethosa, Iris Versicolor, Iris Virginica, count. Each class is of 50 instances. Weightage is 50. Total is what? 150. Last class, I asked you, what is missing values? Missing values are 0. Distinct values are how many? What is this? 3 distinct values. What is this uniqueness? 0%. What type of attribute it is? Tell me, what type of attribute is the class label? Class, what type of attribute it is?
Categorical data.
Categorical data, very good. But why it is mentioned nominal? You told 100% correct. It's a categorical data. What's my question? Why they mentioned type nominal? Is there any reason behind that? Can we bring some sort of information from that? Why they mentioned like that and all? For example, let us think like this. Because in last class we have seen predictors. How many predictors are here? How many predictors are here? Only 4 attributes. These 4 are the predictors. We are using these 4 predictors to predict the class. Right or not? Please tell me. Means for predicting the target class, for predicting an object related to which target class it is, we are not using this one class, right or not? We are utilizing these things only. Please see, now let us see, supple length is there. What is supple length? What type of attribute it is? Numeric. Please see, he is the last person I am admitting for this class. From 9:15 onwards, I am not going to admit anybody. Right? Please see, supple length. Supple length is, it's a numeric. type data, minimum is 4.3, maximum is 7.9, mean and standard deviation. Right or not? We have discussed about each and everything in last class. Right. Now you see in this visualization what I mentioned. By seeing this tooltip itself, I can say there are 16 instances with the supple length varying from 4.3 to 4.814. Those are of what class? Iris setosa. Right or not? How are you able to tell? Blue color coding is used for iris setosa. Red color coding is used for iris versicolor. For example, I have observed here, supple width. Is it possible to tell the type of treatment? No, it's not at all possible. Only for this, see here. Let me see the tooltip. Yeah. There are two instances with the supple width of 4.2 and 4.1 to 4.4. Those are iris setosa. Right or not? Like that. This is the visualization. This is the knowledge we obtained during last session. Now, coming to this session, please see. Supple length. Yeah. Now tell me, what is this? It's a numeric value. What we observed during theoretical classes, numeric values, if it is a real value, is it continuous or discrete? Friends, please, I need response from you. Is it continuous or discrete?
Continuous.
Very good. Continuous. That's why we are able to see the visualization continuously. Right or not? What about this one? It's a nominal attribute. We know it is a categorical attribute, right or not? Is it continuous? Is it continuous?
No, sir.
Very good. No, this is discrete. That's why there is no continuous visualization from one bar to another bar. There is no continuous visualization from one bar diagram to another bar chart, right or not? That information you need to extract from the visualization, petal length. What type of attribute it is, petal length? Numeric. Is it continuous or not? Continuous. That's why in this bar diagram visualization, from this rectangle to other rectangle is, there is no gap. Continuity is there. That we can observe by simply seeing the visualization. Whereas, by simply seeing the file data set in the form of text, you can't bring this knowledge. That's why lot of research is going on visual data mining. Okay, visual data mining. Now, the next point is, how can I convert from this numeric value to discrete value? What is the concept we learn? Please, response. What is the concept we called? Conversion of numeric data to discrete data, conversion of continuous data to discrete data, or conversion of numeric data to categorical data. What is the name we have given? No one is responding.
Attribute transformations.
Okay, attribute transformation. That is okay. Straight away I told, na? Are you not able to recollect discretization? Please tell me. Right? Discretization. What is discretization? Discrete means finite number. Continuous means infinite. Right or not? Discrete, finite. How many divisions are there? Only 4 divisions. How many students completed from 60.00 to 70.00? It's a different value, right or not? But whereas how many total divisions are there? 4 divisions. Past class, second class, first class and the first class with a distinction, right or not? Like that. Now let me see the pre-processing in Weka. Pre-processing is called filter. Please see. Hope you are able to see the filter. Let me select one sort of pre-processing technique. Choose filters. What type of filter you want to use? Please see. Basically, all data mining techniques are 2 types. One is supervised and unsupervised. Supervised means what? Like this. Whatever the training I am giving, whatever the guidance I am giving, and I am asking you to do. Right? This is supervised. What is unsupervised? Completely self-learning concept. there is no point of guidance. You need to prepare on your own like that. For example, classification. There are several techniques we have seen. If you remember, data mining tasks, classification, clustering, regression analysis, association rule mining, like that. Several tasks are there. Out of those tasks, clustering is unsupervised, classification is supervised technique. Why? Because in classification, we will divide the data set into two parts. One is training data and second one is the test data. Training data is used to train the model. Test data is used to evaluate the model. Please remember this concept, right? Now I am not going to give anything. That's why I am selecting the unsupervised, right? Next concept is on what based, either attribute based or instance based. What is this? You know, attribute is the column name. Instance is row, number of objects. I don't want to divide the data set uniformly. Means I want to convert attribute. Now my goal is I want to convert numeric data to discrete data. I want to convert continuous data to discrete data. I want to convert numeric data to categorical data. That's why it is related to the attribute. I have selected the attribute. What technique you want to use? These all are the several techniques are there. Please see, is there discretization or not? Are you able to see discretize? Please, I want response.
Yes, sir.
Right, I have selected this discretization. Please see, discretize, minus B, those are the switches, right? While writing Java program, we will give 10, M, 1.0, R, first, last, precision 6. What is this? These all are the options. Let us click on this. Click on this, please see. An instance filter. Filter is nothing but a pre-processing technique in Weka. Pre-processing technique is called filter in Weka. An instance filter that discretizes a range of numeric attributes in the data set into what attributes, Andy? Nominal attributes. He told numeric to nominal attributes. No problem. Please see. Attribute indices are first to last. All attributes I want to select now. Bin range precision. Accuracy is 6 digits. Let us say reduce 3 digits. No problem. How many number of bins? What is this bins? I told na, discretization is the name. Binning is the technique. Okay? Binning is the one sample technique used to discretize. Let us say number of bins are 10. Ignore about that. Let us divide first as it is. As it is. Okay. Please see. Friends, please see, before I am going to apply discretization, before this, please see how many distinct values are here on petal length. How many distinct, Andy? Response is important. How many distinct values are here? 43. Why you are not able to see and tell? Uniqueness is what? 10. 7% uniqueness is there. Now, let me press this apply button. Please observe the visualization also. Yes, I have pressed on the apply button. Yeah. Have you observed the change or not? Previously what? Petal length I have selected. Please see. Petal length. Missing values are 0. Right. Distinct values are 9. Type nominal. Uniqueness is 0. There is no point of uniqueness. Right or not? Please see. Infinity to minus 1.59. Minus infinity to 1.5759. 1.59 to 2.18. 2.18 to 2.77. Means, what is the minimum value of petal length? And what is the maximum value of petal length? By taking that range, it has divided simply by 10. Okay? Means it has created 10 ranges. 10 ranges. First range is minus infinity to 1.59. Means, if you put this tooltip, please see, what is the meaning here? Out of 150, there are 37 instances which is having less than 1.59 petal length. Those are 37 instances, those are related to Iris setosa. Okay, are you able to observe this statement or not? Are you able to understand this statement or not? If you are able to understand, my job is over. If you are not able to understand, need to see once again. Very simple visualization. What about this? If I put, what is the tooltip here? Please see. Anyone, please read this. Now tell me your observation by seeing this visualization. Can anyone tell? Or not? Please don't waste our time, please. At least try, you can try na. You all are creamy layer students. What you observed from this? Okay, I am repeating. There are 18 instances with petal length varying from 5.13 to 5.13 to 5.72. Those are what type of class? Iris virginica. Okay. This is the thing you need to observe. This is the thing we have explored from the data set. Sepal width. Yes, please see. Here distinct values are how many? 10. Why in case of petal length 9? Because it has not observed. It has not observed any value of petal length varying from 2.18 to 2.77. Please see. Because we have not performed filtering or binning based on instances. We have performed based on the attribute value. Please remember, this is an important task. Okay. We have not performed on instance based. We have performed on attribute based. That's why 2.18 to 2.77, there is no instance. Total distinct values are 9. Uniqueness, of course, 0. Whatever attribute you can select, uniqueness is 0 only. Here, sepal length. How many different values? 10 values. Those 10 values are nothing but this 10. Sir, can I change this value? Yes, please. Why not? Let us change that 10 to 6. Okay. Again, please see that modification is applied. Visible here. Press apply button. Press it or not, please see. Yes, apply. You observe this diagram. Okay, again I am loading the data set, please see. I am loading the data set. It will apply, there will not be no doubt. I am selecting discretization. Here continuous values, yes, applied. How many now? Please see, how many bins are there?
Six
bins. Why you are not responding, Andy, please? Response is very, very important. Am I audible or not? Please, anyone?
Yes, sir.
Yes, very good. I am audible now. Try to answer, what is there? If it is, there is no problem now. You can tell something by seeing this visualization. What you can tell? What you can observe from this? There are 7 instances with sepal length varying from greater than 7.3. Greater than or equal to 7.3. Those 7 are related to Iris virginica. That's all. Emundamma Indra, why you are not even trying? Don't hesitate. Nothing, you are not going to get anything by simply keeping silent. See, how many? 0. Here also bins. Like this. You can perform pre-processing. You can convert numerical value into nominal value, or numerical into discrete categorical, continuous value into discrete value, right? The name is called discretization. Now, shall I stop here? Anyway, by next class, we will get the concept of classification. Let us see. Let me explore for 5 more minutes. Please see classification. What classifier is here? 0R. 0R is also a decision tree classifier. Or you can see there are several decision tree classifiers. See, please select a tree-based classifier. Recollect J48. Please use this J48 classifier. Using training set, I am not supplying separately training set. I have not supplied test set, cross-validation, or percentage split. Simple thing is percentage split. Let us divide the data set into, here 150 samples are there. Out of 150 samples, two-thirds is for test set, sorry, training set. One-third is for test set. Next, start. Please see, classifier output, nothing is here. Right, nothing is here. I have pressed the start button. You can observe this completed output. How much time it took? 0.05 seconds. Please spend 5 minutes, friends. This is very, very important concept. Running information scheme. Weka.classifiers.trees. Why this is? In Java, what notation you use? Package, class, method. What separator you will use? That only, na? Same. Relation, Iris Weka filters unsupervised. Please see, Iris Weka filters, it used unsupervised filtering, attribute based and discretized with 6 bins. Right or not? Instances means original Iris ERFF is as it is. Whenever you got the output from the pre-processing filtering, the file is changed to this name. That's all. Total instances are 150. Attributes are 5. This is, we know, test mode. Split is 66.0. Means training set is 66. Remainder is the test set. Classifier model, full training set. Please see. This is the J48 pruned tree. Please remember, what is this pruned tree? J48, what is this J48? If possible, try to explore. Maybe during next week, we will discuss about classification in class, during classwork, theory, while handling the theory classes. But what is the top portion petal length? Petal length is minus infinity to 1.983. Right or not? What is this? Iris setosa. 50 samples are there. Petal length 1.983 to, yes, please see some sort of visualization. Please see, by seeing this thing, you should be in your position to draw the decision tree. How many number of leaves are here? 11. Size of the tree, 13. Time taken to build the model, 0.05 second. Please see, evaluation on test split. Summary, correctly classified instances are how many? 49. Incorrectly classified instances, 2. This is wrong classification. Accuracy of the model is 96.0784. Like this, you need to observe this. Next class, we will discuss in detail about these things. First, please see this tree. Visualize the tree. Visualize the tree. What you observed by seeing the visualization? Please tell me. What you observed by seeing the visualization?
Decision
tree. Observed? Ma, chepadra.
Decision tree.
Very good. Decision tree. What is root node?
Petal length.
Right. Petal length is the root node. Why it has selected petal length? My question is this.
How many attributes are there? How many predictors?
Four attributes.
Oh, no? Petal length, petal width, sepal length, sepal width. Four attributes are there. Out of the four, why it has selected petal length? This is the question. My question is what? Please tell me. At least let me know whether you understood my question or not.
Yes, sir.
What is that question?
Why petal length is taken as a root node?
Very good. Excellent, Amma. Try to answer this. By next class, try to answer this. I will stop now. Okay. Please prepare. In next class, we will see all these things. Or you can spend some time. 1 minute. Confusion matrix. Now you see, total samples are how many? 150. Two-thirds is test set. Ante enta 100. Remaining training set is 50 only. Those 50 were classified, 51 you got. Those 51 were classified like this. How? Please see, total number of instances, 51. A, B, C, confusion matrix. A is iris setosa. B is iris versicolor. C is iris virginica. How I need to read? 15 samples of iris setosa identified, predicted as iris setosa only. Excellent. There are 19 samples with versicolor. All 19 samples were correctly predicted as iris versicolor only. Please see last statement. There are 17 samples of iris virginica out of this 51. Okay. 15 samples were correctly predicted as iris virginica and 2 samples were wrongly predicted as iris versicolor. This is the statement. This is the knowledge you need to observe from the confusion matrix. This is called the confusion matrix. Okay. Hope you can understand. Please go through that. We will discuss the remaining portions in next class. Have you understood?
Yes, sir. Students.
Yes, thank you. Almost 57 students are available now. I want to know, please share your feedback. If you have any doubts, you can raise now. It's open. Let the session is open for 2 minutes for clarifying your doubts. If you want to ask any doubt, you can. Please, Anil Kumar, chapandi. Anil Kumar, please read, please. ఏనా అనిల్ కుమార్ మాట్లాడటం లేదు, ఏదో మాట్లాడబోయాడు, మాట్లాడలేదు. ఎనీ అదర్, ఎనీ అదర్, ఆర్ డూ యూ ట్రై టు షేర్ యువర్ ఫీడ్బ్యాక్ యూజింగ్ ది గూగుల్ ఫామ్, యూజింగ్ గూగుల్ ఫామ్ కెప్ట్ ఎట్ మై హోమ్ పేజ్. ప్లీజ్ సీ దిస్ స్ట్రైట్ అవే. యూ కెన్ గో టు లెక్చర్ నోట్స్ ఆన్ డేటా మైనింగ్ అండ్ ఫీడ్బ్యాక్ ఫామ్. You can share your feedback without seeing feedback. I will not. Okay? Whatever you want. You are no need to reveal even your identity. Just please simply means what you want. Topic of discussion is VECA. Let us say VECA filter. Right? Like this you can. What is your answer? Means in what? Discretization. Attribute based DISCRETIZATION. This is sufficient. I can go through that. Attribute based discretization. Okay. Submit. See, it is not even asking any. Right or not? How those are available means I can go through. Please see, I can go through the Google Drive. These queries were stored. Feedback form. Please see. Why? Because I want to be very transparent with you. Please see. Yeah. Same form I am using for